Hello dear students, welcome to the lecture 8 of Introduction to Programming 2 with C# course, as known as also Advanced Programming. So today we are going to continue from where we have left with our patient management system software development. Okay, I will start with duplicating the previous lecture source code as usual. Okay, and let's duplicate it. All right, let's start the application. So if you remember, we have a table of such to have drugs, prescriptions, treatments, users, user types, diseases, and such. And in the previous lecture, we have completed registration and login and logout. So now we can start adding prescriptions and other things to our software. Okay, so let's start with renaming our lectures. This does not rename everything, but still better than nothing. Okay. Okay, let's run our application to remember the interface, and then we can continue programming our patient management system application. All right, it is getting opened. Okay, it is taking a bit of time since the first time starting. All right, application is starting. Okay, so this was our register interface, and this was our login interface. And when we log in, let's check our users table to see some emails. When we log in, it should disable register and login tabs. However, I don't know if we had coded them yet. Yeah, we have coded them. Okay, so these tabs are disabled. I should also clear these, but it is up to you. You can clear it or not. And login button should also be disabled also logically. And logout button should only be appearing. Let's also disable login button as well. So how we gonna do it? We are going to change the login button status, and where was it? Here. What we are going to do is we will simply duplicate this code and get. Okay. Why it is happening like this? Okay, interesting. Okay, BTN login. Yeah, we will just change the login to opposite of, I mean the enable status of login to opposite of. Okay, so everything is fine. Yes, now we can start coding our logged in operations. What kind of operations we would expect? We would expect a interface to add drugs, and interface to add prescriptions and treatments, perhaps an interface to modify users. It is like an admin panel. So I will start with adding a drugs interface. So let's edit after login. Here I'm going to just copy and paste this code to here. And tab item. Okay. And it will be tab drugs. Let's make the header as drugs. Okay. So on this interface, we should have, actually we can have a single interface as well. Yeah. Let's use a data grid. Okay. I think it should be what satisfying to add drugs adding system. Yeah, I'm going to add a data grid. Currently it is taking the full space, so let's change the dimensions a little bit, perhaps something like this. Okay, so we can have several buttons such as refresh, load, save and such. And actually I will add a refresh button. Okay, refresh drugs list. Okay, this will be a refresh button and we will also have a save button. So let's start coding the refresh button. BTN refresh drugs. All right. As I have mentioned previously, I want to minimize the code that I write in main window class. And therefore, I am going to add another class as logout in operations. Let's add it to our project. I don't need any template for this, but let's see, add class. Let's name it as okay, here. Okay, I'm going to name it as logout in operations. It will be a public static class. All right, and I don't even need try. So I have to give a name to these data grids that so that I can access it, and name will be DT or data grid drugs. Okay. Okay, and this will call here static void refresh drugs data grid. Okay. And what this is going to do is it will get the data from database and bind it to drugs data grid. So in order to do that, I am going to define a private static let's say context of my TBL. How should I make it? Yeah, TBL drugs. Okay, drugs data. Okay, and we are going to using okay, so what was our context? It was, let's get it from somewhere here, perhaps. Yeah, let's get it from Okay, I have remembered it. So it will be PMX context. And but maybe I need a different context for this. I'm not sure. Yeah, this wouldn't work. Probably I needed PMX context for drugs data, and I have to initialize it and use it. So if drugs data is equal to null, we are going to make okay drugs data new PMX context. Okay, this way we will have it initialized. Okay, actually I can initialize it here as well. Okay, what this is going to do is from global methods we have main, and from there we are going to have get data grid drugs binding or source item source. Yeah, gets or sets a collection used to generate the context of the system Windows control item control equal to drugs data dot tbl drugs dot select. So this would select everything. Therefore, I will just pick the top use, top 100. So how am I going to do that? This select requires a selector. Or maybe we need to use take, yeah, 100, and we should order them by PR dot drug ID. Okay, this will be ordering them by drug ID ascending, and this will be the item source. Okay, so let's test whether it is working or not, and then we can continue. So this will be inside login in operations, refresh data, drugs data grid. Okay, let me do a check. Item source data grid save. Okay. Data context. Yeah, it could be context as well. I am not sure. Observable collection. Maybe this is the way. Let's see. Okay, drugs should be disabled, but it is not yet because we are just doing tests. Populate a DB set with data, for example, going load on DB set, then bind to local data. Okay, so what we need to search is this one. Okay, so how are we gonna do it? I see. But I also need to reflect the changes, therefore How should we do it? I have done this in another project, so maybe we should check it there. Yeah, why not? Why should we research it? And where did we do it? I think it was in my object-oriented course. So inside the source code, let's look for item source. And let's see. It didn't search. Okay, from our YouTube channel. This type. Okay, wasn't here. Polymorphism. No, not this one as well. Did we show it in one moment? Oh. Maybe we have shown that in lecture 5, yeah. Lecture 5, and let's check our code. But probably not, no. Oh, here, okay. So we have made an example here, and where is the save? Here, okay. So my context, school context, order by load. Okay, we use load, yeah. After loading that, we use local to binding list. Okay, so this is the way it is. Okay, now I remember. So take and load. Okay. Take order by, then load. Okay. After that, we are going to use this as equal to, okay, drugs data, TBL drugs local to binding list. Yeah, yes. Okay, take order by. Maybe we need to order by like this, then take, then no. Okay, there is no load. Let me check something. Why there is no load? Because probably it was requiring a reference. Let's see. Yeah, we need to add using Microsoft Entity Framework Core. It will come here. Yes, this is it. So let's add a node. Okay, now it should work. Let's retry. Why we are making it this way is when we make changes, we want it to automatically save it back to database. We could do it manually, for scanning grid and getting every change, but we don't want that. Okay, so you see it also shows empty rows tables as well, and you see now I am adding a new drug. By the way, it is, let's see, it is identity or not, it is primary key, but it is, yes, it is also identity, therefore I won't be touching this. So those milligram 25, let's find some real drugs. For example, let's add the coronavirus drug. Okay, COVID-19 user drugs. Okay, let's see which drugs are being used. So it is an up-to-date topic also. Okay, they are loading really slow. Okay, remdesivir, how many milligrams is it displayed here? Let's look for remdesivir on the internet. Yeah, let's type the milligrams perhaps. Okay, 100 milligrams and TBL prescriptions. Okay, so why do we didn't have that in the list? Because it is bound to that. And after I have made these changes, I need to save. So when I refresh, is it added? Probably not, but let's check. Yeah, when I refresh the table, it is keeping that. It is not removing the non-existing bars, so maybe we need to do a refresh of items. How are we gonna do that? Items, refresh. I also need to hide a data column, which is columns. Which column is that? It is the third or fourth column. Let's type its name with, it was TBL prescriptions and visibility will be equal to hidden. Yeah, we don't need that. And okay, it requires okay, so we have to set it with so let's look for another way for each columns. This is expecting an integer index. Maybe there is a better way. Yeah, so the better way would be getting this number dynamically. Count, and if, okay, columns I to string equal to, okay, TBL prescriptions, we will just hide it. Okay, and then why I am doing this way, so if I add more columns to the drugs table, I wouldn't be need to change this code. Okay, this provides me more flexibility and more freedom and easier to manage code. Okay, so when I make a change to my table, I won't be needed to change this code again. So I will just hide that column because we don't need that. Refresh. Okay, I see. So it didn't match because it's let's say first letter is bigger, therefore I will make it as to string and to lower invariant is equal to TBL prescriptions to lower invariant. Yeah, now it should work. So this will prevent non-matching string comparison. Oh, it is again here. So let's debug and see why not working. Okay, so columns, it has four columns. Okay, there is some more information. Maybe column name or something. Okay, there is header. Yeah, we have to check the header. You see why it is important to do debug, because we have to check header. Okay, now they can match. Yeah, let's retry. Okay, you see now it is working. And let's add save button as well. So we will be able to modify, add, delete, remove drugs as we want. We also need to add a delete button as well. Yeah. And how are we gonna do it? So let's add a button here to save them. Etn save. Okay, save table list. Save drugs changes or updates, let's say. And this will be like this. Okay, we also need to a way to delete them. How can we do that? I think we can add a button to data grid. How can we do it? Let's check it on the Google. This button will let us delete a record. But we also need to have we need to add it to each row. Add column of top data grid div button column. Okay, we need to check it for VPF because it may be different on Windows Forms. No, this is not the way we want. Okay, later it dynamically. Okay. Okay, this is the question that we are asking. Okay, and okay, this looks like a good solution, so let's check it out. So after we set it, data grid text column. What is this call property? This is the name. So the name will be delete. Okay. And let's see what we need. We need Windows controls. We need Windows data. Windows documents. Interesting. And we have column property here. We also need a plus event for it will be equal to top, not button click, but let's say delete row. Okay, and yeah, and content will be delete. And I don't know if this will work or not. We may need to make some try. So here I am trying to add a button to each row so that we can easily delete them. We can update them already with changing data, and with this way we can delete them. So refresh. Okay, delete or edit only here, not here. So it was supposed to be here, but it is not. Maybe it is because there weren't any data in the database. So let's add some data and then retry. So drug ID we don't set, we will set drug name. Okay, let's say drug one, it is not important. And save, then refresh. Okay, it is adding. Let's add another one, 200. Drug two, save, refresh. Let's change values and refresh again. Refresh. Okay, it is not getting refreshed either. So for refreshing, I think we had something else. Refresh here. Maybe it was in lecture 6. Items clear. No. Let's see if the save worked. Yeah, save didn't work either. Because we haven't coded the save button yet. Yes, we have to first code it. So it is. So let's try. Okay, public static void, save changes. And it will save the context changes. like this, save changes, okay, and we will call it save changes, or let's say save drug changes, okay, and logout in operations, save drug changes. Let's first try whether our change is working or not. Then we can work on the delete button. We can also add another text box and force user to type ID of the drug to delete it. But we can also add easier way. So that's what I am working on. Let's add 100. Okay, drug one. Okay, let's save drug. And let's see. Okay, it is added. Refresh. Refresh working. You see ID has arrived. Let's 200. Drug 2. Okay, and save. Let's see. Okay, let's refresh. Refresh working, but these values are not getting updated. So let's also look for that data grid. Okay, someone has also asked it that. Items clear. Which items do we clear? Let's look to code. Maybe we should use this. Yes. Let's retry. But I am not sure if this will work or not. Refresh, change, refresh. Okay, we got an error. So first we need to nullify item source. Okay, well, which methods there are nothing. So let's set null, then clear. Yeah, let's try this way. Still not deleted, and okay, so we need to probably delete the columns or columns clear, maybe rows clear as well. Let's try this. Okay, refresh. No. Okay. But it is not working. Okay, it says refresh. Maybe our local data is not getting refreshed. It is also another possibility. Let's check it out. Okay, so maybe we need to refresh the local. Yeah, probably we need to refresh the local. So how do we refresh it? Okay, refresh the context. Okay, so it is about dispose and reload. There is refresh. Okay, so it looks like our best option is refreshing the context like this each time. Then we just need to nullify item source, or we don't probably even need that. We just need to refresh here. Let's retry. So each time when we hit refresh button, we are going to recompose the context. So the local cache will be also deleted. However, I have to do it at the beginning, of course. Here, this will refresh local data. And then only thing left is adding a button to our data grid. Okay, let's change this, refresh. Yes, this time it is fixed. However, we still can't add a button to records. And so that is the next thing that we have to solve. Add a column, or let's say add a button to all rows of data grid C#. Okay, let's see how it can work. Adding a button to data grid. Oh, I think we can even use, but it wouldn't work here. Yeah, not that well. Let's see. Adding, removing rows in data grid. Yeah, how can we do that? Okay, there is select and this is too much. Maybe some easier way. I see. So it would require us to type everything. But that can be the easiest way. There can be other ways as well. Yeah, this would be better. So I will also remove this code and this code. So here we are using order by, and we are going to use select and okay, new object probably. Let's see the syntax. Does it automatically populate it? New. I see. So this will be the show. Okay. Rack name equal to PR dot rack name. So here we are setting the column names and their assigned values. So it will be like this. And then first maybe like this. Okay, title, code ID. Must be a variable property or indexer. Okay, let's make it like this. Same. So this will be an anonymous type string drug name. I see. Okay. Drug ID will be equal to pr.drugID. Drug name, and then we need drug dose. Dose will be equal to pr.drug dose, and then we are going to have a fake value as delete button will be equal to delete drug. Okay, let's retry. So we are here we are setting the selection of elements, which columns and which names we want to pick. Okay, let's see, will it work or not? Okay, so we have drug ID dose. No, it didn't work. Why? Maybe we need to put order by after that. Select and then order by and then take and load. Yeah, let's try like this. So there is where group by and select. Okay, it didn't work either. Interesting. Let's see which query it is running. To see the query, I am going to run the SQL profiler. Okay, it is selecting top and drug ID, drug name, drug dose. Okay, drug milligram is selected as drug dose. Okay, and delector, yeah, the query is correct, but it is not bound to our data grid. Why? Okay, anonymous type selection. Okay. So populating data grid with anonymous type collection. Yes, this is what we need. Okay. Okay, this is the same. So this is item source. Okay. Okay. Enter anonymous type local. Maybe this is the key that we need to look for. Okay, this is just getting, but we also need to binding, therefore. To binding list. Okay, to binding list. Okay, so we need an extension. Yeah, it looks like a clear one. Okay, static class my extensions binding list T. Binding list. Okay, so it should work like this. Okay, so let's add this to our global methods. It's an extension. Okay, it will be here. And then, oh, I need to add component model here. Here, yeah. Okay, and then we are going to return to binding list. Okay, I will just let it here. Will be equal to take to binding list. Why it is not here? Okay, first to list, then to not binding list. Okay. Okay, to list and then to binding list. Let's see. Yeah, then we will use this binding list as the item source. Okay, let's see if it will work. Okay, refresh is working. So what we need is, but they are not editable right now, as you can see. They are just there. So this doesn't solve our problem. So we have to assign this to local. Okay. Entity framework load anonymous type to local cache. Okay. So how do we load them to local? Okay, so we need to somehow load. So that, what does load? Let's try something. So drugs data and TBR drugs local. So this is a local and it's only get. And there is two binding list. Union zip to observable collection. There is take. No. Remove select. Okay, there's append. It requires TBL drugs elements. And there is add. Okay. So adds a new enter to the DB context if enter is not in the market already. Edit. So we may use add and it requires an item. So perhaps we can use this. I will keep the rest like this. Then is there any add range? No. So let's make this command for each. Let's set a drugs. Okay, drugs data, TBL drugs local at item. So this item should be a TBL drug item. Oh no, It's an anonymous type. Maybe it is not possible to do it with anonymous type and loading. I'm not sure. Maybe what we are trying is impossible to achieve. Yeah, maybe it is not possible to load anonymous type into local tracking. Okay, let's see. Entity framework, anonymous type, local tracking changes. Let's see. Okay, someone else asked it this. Okay, of course you can't update the database via anonymous type. The anonymous type has no idea about database. Okay. Take object approach like this. Okay, so what we wanted to achieve appears to be not possible. Okay, therefore we will continue with our usual method, which is loading and not an anonymous type. So it will be like this. And then we will use TBL drags local. So it will be able to save and refresh as well. So for refreshing, yeah, it will refresh and it will save. But we still don't have a way to add a button to our table, and I will also achieve that. Okay, so delete row button. How to edit? Okay, we need something like this, yes. And var delete button, name, header, text, use column text for value true. Okay, how do we do that? If you prefer the raw image, we don't need that. And then click record. Var delete button, new data grid. This is data grid view. Probably this wouldn't work. We need a data grid, not a data grid view. No. VPF data grid, yeah. We are not using data grid view. We are using data grid. They are different. No, not this one. We need a programmatic way. Let's see, VPF data grid row add button. Okay, so every example is auto-generate columns force, but we are doing auto-generate columns true. So maybe this is the way. Then BPF auto generate column. No, none of these are the things that we need. Okay. No. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's go with the basic and simpler way. So instead of having a button to in each data row, I will just add additional text box and a button to delete them. So one moment, why do we have that? Okay, here. So let's make it that way. Maybe I could find a solution, but it's taking too much time. Therefore, let's add a text box and yeah, where did our design go? Okay, so let's add it to here. Okay, and then it will have the ID of drag for deleting. Okay, let's add a label. This is the simpler way. A more complex and better way could be found. For example, if I were doing this project, I would ask on Stack Overflow whether it is possible or not. But currently, I don't want to spend more time. So I will just go with this easier way. Drag ID, it will be TXT drag ID, and then I will have delete. Okay. But I will also add a warning message to this button. So let's also code that delete. Let's say we can also make it something like delete selected. Yeah, maybe that would be better. Yeah, let's make it that way. Not this way, but okay, let's make it as delete selected drag. This is a more appropriate way. Instead of adding a button to each element, we will make sure that the user selected that and then they can click. Okay, btn delete selected drag. Okay, so we also need an on click element, on click event, I mean. Okay, this will simply call delete selected drag. And let's compose that event on here. So simply This will delete the selected row and I think there should be a lot of answers to this one. So selected item. Yeah, it is simple like this. So we will use main dot actually global dot main. Okay, data grid drags selected item. And it will just simply remove it, but not that is enough. Then we need to call save drug changes. And then we need to call refresh here. So first we will save, then we will refresh. Okay, and but we can still let user to delete, yes. That may be better. So not just save it. We can do it. Yeah, let's user to decide whether save or not. Okay, so let's try. Oh, we also need to hide our column again since we have removed. So let's hide it. Let's write that code again. It will be a waste of time, but what can we do? We can't do anything. So it will be like this. Okay, columns, and then if columns headers. To string dot to lower invariant is equal to drug descriptions. Okay, I know visible count. We will just visibility set hidden. Okay. And let's run the application and let's see if our saving, adding, and deleting works. Okay. Oh, we need to set to binding list. We have forgotten that. Binding list. Like this, and yeah, complete it. Okay. Refresh, yes. But TBL prescription still there. Probably we have, yeah. TBL prescriptions. Let's restart. You see it also shows an additional empty row so that we can add new records. That is why there is additional row. All of this could be done with low level programming as well. And it would provide us more flexibility, but with easiness we lose some flexibility. So let's change this struct tree and let's save changes and then refresh and refresh again. Yes, it is saved. So let's also check in our database. It is here. Let's delete this record. By the way, there is also additional column here. I don't know why there is. We can also check that. Let's select the deleted drug. Okay, operation is not valid by item source in use. So how to delete it? We need to delete it from item source. Okay, so let's say Okay, let's check this way. I know how to delete it, but maybe a better way. Okay, so we need to delete the item from our local. How are we gonna do that? We are going to do it with using our item source, which is local to binding list. Therefore, we need to use remove, and it is taking item TBL drugs. So we are going to get that item with select equal to PR dot drug ID is equal selected item dot. Yeah, from this selected item, I have to get the selected item ID. So let's debug and see what is getting selected. You see how do I utilize the debugging? It is extremely useful features. Okay, I have selected this item and then okay, delete selected drug. So the selected item is okay. So I can simply get drug ID with its feature. Okay, so what we are going to do is simply convert this dynamically to TBL drugs. Okay, now the values will appear. Selected item dot drug ID and remove. Okay, so why it didn't work? We have a set. Maybe we need to where. And I need to get first or default. Okay, let's try. If nothing is selected, this may cause an unexpected error, so we should also check that as well. And let's see. Okay, refresh list. Let's click. Okay, no error. Let's click. Okay, it is deleted, and when it is deleted, you see it is deleted here, but not save it yet. Because when I refresh the list, I will see it. When I delete and save, and now it is saved. Okay, it is working as expected. Everything is working. So for example, when I delete it but not save it, it is not deleted at the database yet. So when I save the drug updates, then it is deleted. Okay, everything is working. I think this was also a great solution. However, still we have an extra column here. So let's also find why do we have an extra column. Let's add another drug 5, save, refresh, yes, and let's see where this extra column comes. So we have four columns, which are display index 3. So the third column is, let's see, what is the name, header of the column. Okay, drug name. And the fourth one is, let's see. Okay, so it is not visible here, therefore it must be related to auto-filling. And let's find it. Okay, auto-generated data grid displays additional column. Let's find the reason. Okay, let's say auto-generated grid extra column. Okay, someone has also asked it. You see extra column here. So what is the reason? Okay, the extra column is actually unused space. Each of your column defines bit value. So once they get assigned, there is a space left over. If you want to get the space, make at least one of your columns. Okay, star, so it stretches. Okay, so from programmatic view, maybe we can change it after here. Okay, for example, let's see if we can make the column width something bigger, width equal to, or let's say to generate it with header. Okay, and max width, min width. Which one is we can set it? Okay, let's see. Data grid auto generated leftover space. Okay, so here, yeah. And then we need to use columns I equal to data grid view. But there is no auto size. Maybe this can work. Let's see this width. New data grid length 1. Okay, let's try this. Maybe it will work. So you see it says star, therefore it will stretch to all space. And I am setting that true for everything. Since we are doing an auto-generated table, it is harder to achieve. Yes, now it is gone. And each column is set equally on my screen. Okay. Okay, okay. Okay, great. Now it is working as we want. Okay, so let's add some message interface so that the user can know the results of their actions. Okay. So I'm going to put a label here. And let's give it a name. Also, let's add some different layout. What I mean is appearance. For example, Comic Sans MS 16 pixels. Okay. And what kind of messages we can add? Okay. We can add as. Okay. Content. Okay, it will be available here. Okay, drag screen content equal to. Actually, let's add a private method. Okay, and okay, changes. Okay, and we don't need this anymore. Once a new record added, how can we know it? We need to add an event to do our local context, perhaps. How can we know it? Okay, so data grid view rows added event. So I think we can do it with our local binding list and let's see. Okay, fire an event when its data changes. No, there is no events fire or change, only when you do save changes. Maybe we can bind an event to local, such as, let's see. There is maybe at event. Okay, there is collection changed. Yeah, that may work. That's an event. You see, events are differently displayed. There is property changed. There is property changing. Okay, so we can use property changed or collection changed. And let's see where what is this property change. This is entity framework. Okay. Okay, I think let's make it something like this. Let me show. I will add an event as plus equal. It should automatically let us compare. Okay, let's see. Property changes top. Okay, I did double tap and it has generated a local property changed event. I will name it as drag local property change it. Okay, and here What am I going to do is you have unsaved changes. You have unsaved changes. Or maybe we can check that with, let's see. Okay, so there is a good quote here, which is exactly what I need. And so what we are going to do is, it is using context object state manager. So it will be, okay, drugs data, object state manager. Why there is no? It is not available. Maybe here. Let's see if there is object state manager or something similar. And type. Maybe it is in local. Collection changed event. Okay, I think we can use this event. But maybe there is a better way. Change tracker. Okay, yes, there is change tracker and there is context and let's see what are there, what options there are. Okay, there is deleted changes, detect changes, yes, test changes, yes, and what kind of changes there are, how can we know? Oh, here, context change tracker, entries edit, yes, this is the way we want. Okay, so here what we are going to use is, it will be our context change tracker entries, and here we are going to use entries edit count, yeah. Okay, this is not any, but I think where and then we can use count. Okay. Okay, so this will be and you have awaiting to be saved in database. Okay, you have awaiting X number of changes. How many? You have awaiting. Okay, number of new entries. Number of new drugs to be saved in the database. Yes. And we will continue. Okay, it will be plus equal. By the way, I think Okay, let's make it simpler. It is not important. New drugs. Okay. And then okay, there is updated, modified. Yeah. This is added, this is modified, and it will be modified. New, let's say, yeah, new, modified, deleted, and this will be deleted. Okay, drugs to be updated, to be saved. So we will just push this and let's see if it will work. So we are getting the state, but this is getting the entire state. I wonder if we can get the state of only TBL drugs. So let's try it. If there is change tracker for TBL drugs, maybe local. No. So maybe here where and E dot entity. There's collections. Entity equal. Can we use this? Oh, this should work. Yeah, we don't need this because this drugs data is only available to this screen. Therefore, we don't need to make a change because we are using this only for drugs table. Okay. Therefore, we don't need to filter certain table to be changed or not. We can get entire. Okay, refresh and see. Okay. Okay, our event is not fired and therefore this is not the event we wanted. So what we want is probably okay, collection change event. And yeah, top. Okay, one moment. Okay, let's see if it is using the same. Yeah, we will use this one. So we don't need this event probably. Let's delete it and retry. If this doesn't work, I will try another way. Okay, this is not firing as well. So probably we need to bind an event to our data grid. Okay, let's check the which events there are. There is adding new item event. And there is beginning edit event. Cell edit ending event. Column display index changed event. Okay, you see there are so many events. Context menu opening, copying row, current cell change it. Data context change it. Yeah, maybe this should work. I don't know, we will test it out. So let's test it. Data context change it. And no, not working. Okay, let's change it as cell edit beginning or row edit ending, cell edit ending. Remove this. Let's remove these ones so we won't have unrelated things. But this would occur only cell edit ending while cell editing. Okay, there is cell value changed event. Yeah, there is cell edit ending. Let's try cell edit ending. Maybe it will work better. Okay, zero new modifies. Oh, this is not updated. Interesting. We have, okay, it shows modified one, but it didn't show at the first. Let's refresh. Okay, it shows zero. So I know, I think the reason. The reason is we have to call this after cell edit ended, not ending. So how can we do it? Data context changes. Maybe this would work better. Yeah. And we also need to make this a bigger size. Okay, so in here, data can't exchange it. Here. And okay. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Okay, let's try. Refresh. Okay, and okay. Not this one. Okay. Okay, cell value changed. Why there is no cell value changed? Collection changed perhaps. No later but. Data context current cell
Selected size changes, selection changes, size changes. Current size changes. Maybe this is the way. Yeah. We are looking for a way to.
This is about an event being fired after certain things. What we want is we want to fire an event after our local context is updated. And maybe there's even a better way. Let's see, data grid, item source, change it, event. Yeah, this would be even better one.
Yeah, let's see if there is such event. One item change it. Let's see. Okay, now working. Let's add a new drug as okay, 65, 56 and drug 7. Okay, there is nothing when I click somewhere else. Okay, one new, one modified. Yes. It is now working and let's also delete, for example. Okay, it shows two new because it has a value here. I will delete this. Okay, one new, one modified, zero deleted. Okay, so this one is gone. Why? Oh, because we delete all the selected ones. Okay, let's save. Okay, changes, update, delete are saved at the database. Nice. Let's refresh. Okay, it's here. Let's delete this. Now we have one deleted. Okay, after the delete event, our method is not being fired. Therefore, we need to fire it. And we can do it with simply like this. Okay, I will just send null and null. Okay, now it will show us.
You see, you can simply solve every problem that you encounter with some logical approach, research, and thinking. Okay. So after deleted, okay, you see deleted one drugs to be saved in database. You can show any message any way you want. Okay, so let's disable by default the top of our drugs top, and it will be only available when a doctor user is logged in. I think I will leave it to next lecture because we are already at about 2 hours. So let's add our today's notes here. Okay, lecture context. Enable doc stop only when a doctor okay authority logged in. Okay, so in lecture 8 what we have seen are, let's see, so we have coded data grid, we have, okay, we did set data grid item source to a, okay, where is our login operations here, okay, context,
entity. Yes, with local binding whenever all, or let's say all the changes, or let's phrase it as, okay, let's how to bind data grid to an entity frame or context with local binding, how to track changes of a data grid and save them in the database. Okay, add update grid and insert. Okay. How to fire data grid cell change event and display unsaved at update read insert changes cell modified. Yeah. Okay, what else we have seen? How to get anonymous type results from entity frame select queries. We have also shown how to get anonymous type with this method. So this is the way of getting anonymous type. Here. I think, yeah. Here. Okay. Let's do anonymous custom. Okay, and what else we have seen? Current cell changed. Binding list. Item refresh. How to properly refresh a data grid bound to an entity framework context. Okay, how do we do refresh? We refresh it with refreshing local data cache, and then it will be automatically refreshed by also calling items refresh. Save changes. Okay, display message. Okay. And okay, I think it is enough. This week we have done a lot of research to solve some of the things that are not possible. It is a part of programming, and normally I would also ask Stack Overflow to learn if it is possible or not. I will show you my Stack Overflow account, by the way. So you should also ask your questions in on Stack Overflow if you can't find. So my account is, let me show you, it is almost has the moderator rights. You see I have 491 questions, I have reached 3.3 million people, I have got 20k reputation. You see, yeah, I probably have now moderator tools as well. I have been member of Stack Overflow since 11 years, you see, and so I am at the top overall 2%.
You should also ask your questions. By the time you will learn how to ask questions on Stack Overflow, and yeah, you should also register. You see, my ID is 300K. Probably they have now millions of users. Let's see. So I was one of the first ones who registered Stack Overflow. Let's see how many members they have. I think we can find it with looking the recent queries. Okay. Oh, this is my results. So I will just delete this. And yeah, for example, let's see if this is a new user. Yeah, let's check its ID. You see, the ID is 12 million. So we can assume that, oh, this is a 1 year member. So we should look a new member who is not even a year. Okay, this is 2 months member and ID is 15 million. So Stack Overflow has now over 15 million registered programmers. Okay, so this is a 2 days member. You see 15 million and 600. So you should also register Stack Overflow and ask questions that you cannot find answer. But before asking question, you have to search a lot thoroughly and make sure that there is no answer for that question. Also, take your time and ask your question with details. They like to have you have a specific question. The question shouldn't be broad, shouldn't be unclear. Also, if sometimes you will encounter with members that they will say your answer is not clear or your answer is too broad, those answering people usually don't know the answer, don't know your question. You can just ignore them. However, if you encounter with a person that knows the answer of your question, they will answer. But this is valid only after you have done your research and asked your question with details. Okay. Okay. All right. So end of lecture 8. And by the way, all these codes are link you. So we are basically using link you queries, and they are being translated to database queries. So this is simply var. This is simply a data name, variable name. You can define anything for this. For example, you can set any name as variable name you want, and you also of course have to use it like this. So it is totally fine. This is how the link you works, but over the time you will get used to it. Here we are directly assigning it to label content, because we are not working with threads or tasks at the moment. If we were working with tasks, I would have to use dispatcher to set this. And before closing, let's add more records and see how beautifully they are being displayed on the screen. And let's see. Okay, refresh drugs list, and let's add something, some test. Okay, when I hit enter, it will still work. Okay. You see 4 new, 0 modified. Let's modify something. You see 1 modified. Let's delete. Okay, 1 deleted. And when I save, they will be all saved. I am saving. Okay, changes, update, delete, add are saved. When I refresh, you see new IDs. And they are all selected. I can also delete multiple selected ones. Currently it is deleting only one, but we can do it with something like this. Let me see the selected item. Do we have selected items? Yeah.
So var selected item. If selected item is not one, I think we can now do it like this. For each selected items, and of course we have to convert it to TBL drug, or we can convert it like this. So it will be in selected items, of course. And here, where we are selected equal to TBL drug. Okay, item. And now we will use it. Oh, not this way. Okay, and oh, I have to remove this, yes. And then I will be just using this. Okay, so this should work. Let's try it. So now we can we allow multiple selected item to be deleted at once. It's a nice addition, actually. You see the design, programming, methodology, everything is totally up to you. Let's select multiple items, delete. Okay, there is one. Collection was modified, I see. So, since this is an iList, it's a reference type. Therefore, we are assigning its reference here and they are getting modified. So I have to convert this into a list. And how can I do that? Okay, so okay, I need to set it here. Now it should work. Let's see. But it may not work as well. I'm not sure. So if it doesn't work, we have to find another way. We need to copy it. Let's try, refresh. Okay, still collection was modified. Therefore, we have to get this into a list. Okay, there is no list. So maybe we can find something else. Okay, there is copy to. Copy is the elements of the system collections I collection to an array. Okay, so it uses void. And since this is iList, let's use it. So this is type of multi-selector system command. Windows controls primitives selected items. Okay, so let's see. Okay, there is cast. Oh, I see. So this is even a better way. And so what we are going to do is we are going to cast it to TBL drugs. and then we can cast it to a list. And now we don't even need this. We are struck. And then it will be much easier for us. Okay. So you see, cast can be used for a lot of things. It's a better. Definition. Refresh. Yes, you see now working. Okay, you see there is always a solution. All you need to do is know how to search. Okay, end of lecture 8. Hopefully see you next week.